Hey, it's Jon Hansen, and this is WGN Radio's Your Hometown, and today we're in Homewood. We're in the South Suburbs, a great community, a really cool town, so many things to experience, eat, drink, food. A lot of famous people came from here, so let's check it out.
All right, starting off our tour, I just got to tell you, there are so many parks in the Homewood area. 32 of them, there's recreation spaces spanning over 365 acres. That's 1 acre for every day of the year. They got woodlands, walking paths, so many great things to do outside amongst a lot of green on a gorgeous summer day. There's no shortage of local businesses that can pack a day with eating, drinking, and shopping. Heck, a whole weekend. You got Twisted Q for some great barbecue. Tin Ceiling Tavern, a great place to watch a game, have a brew. Ridgewood Tap has that classic bar look. Lassen's Tap on 183rd has that homey neighborhood pub feel. There's Rabid Brewing, love a good brewery. It's chill, it's got good, really unique beer and a very friendly staff. Heading back downtown to Redbird Cafe, a real friendly spot with great food and pop culture, all sorts of gourmet popcorn with some unique flavors, to say the least. There's Homewood Skate Shop, a place for anything you need that has to do with being on wheels. Serendipity Yoga for all the up dogs and down dogs you need. Mama and Me Pizza with their sizable pies, pasta, and sandwiches. And of course, you can't talk about pizza in Homewood without talking about Aurelio's. Of course, they're all over the place now, but they started in Homewood in 1959. Just a family quality product. There's Lulu Bell, a great shop for picking out a gift for family, friends, or, yeah, for yourself. You can spend the night at La Banks Hotel on Ridge Road. Not a bad place to spend the night after visiting Copper Still Martini Bar. Ooh, yum, a martini bar. Beat the headache from the night before at the martini bar at a Blueberry Hill Pancake House. It's a local favorite. American Dance Center is a great place for kids to learn from passionate teachers. There's Homewood Florist for, well, you guessed it, a great flower selection to make any day special. There's Grady's Snack and Dine with a great patio, eclectic menu too. And look, we're just scratching the surface, but our next stop took us to Homewood Bat Company.
So we started 7 years ago, kind of leveraged some relationships we had between coaches, players. I was familiar with the type of wood, the wood suppliers, machinery from some past business involvement in the baseball industry, and wood bats in particular. And so knowing we had just enough to be a little bit dangerous in the beginning, we took the leap of faith, and I think the first year we did probably about 1,500 bats, and this year we'll do hopefully about 11,000-12,000. Our goal from the beginning was to get a decent number of professional players using it, because we figured if amateur players see professional players using the bat, it kind of validates the quality of the product. Currently, I'd say on average, maybe 8 to 10 big league guys using it and about 70 to 80 minor league guys using it. So when you pool that together, and independent professional players, we have over 100 professional players using our bats, so we're widely and well known in the professional game. And our goal is to expand on the amateur side, where we can sell more bats across the country and even across the world. We've sold bats to, I think, about 10 different countries so far. Homewood has been great to work with. I've worked with the village on a couple of previous building purchases and businesses not related to the bat company. And that was what really gave me the idea of starting the bat company in Homewood and even naming it Homewood. You know, I love the name Homewood, even if it wasn't the town name. Wood with wood bats and home run, home plate, they just go together. It's a good baseball name, but the village has been great to work with. The people are fantastic. The walk-in customers are amazing. They appreciate us being here. We appreciate the community. It just works well for them, hopefully, and certainly for us.
And they made a bat for our producer. Look at that logo. That is so cool. Great stuff there. Okay, let's be honest. One of the reasons Homewood is an attractive place to live and is because it's clean, right? The hardworking folks at Homewood Disposal Services, and they do more than just Homewood. They're providing services to over 80 communities in our area. They've been around since 1956, so they know what they're doing. They've got over 12,000 commercial clients. Think about that. They're out sweeping the streets too, so big shout out to the folks at Homewood Disposal Services. Okay, time to learn a little bit off to the Homewood Science Center. They've been around since 2016. They're a nonprofit all about inspiring scientific wonder, learning, and pursuit.
We offer programs starting at the youngest ages for families with young children. Our STEM Saturdays program, which is free for all. That's our Keystone program, our primary program. And then we go up until children are in eighth grade. There are lots of interactive activities here. So when we're open for a STEM Saturdays, we have a STEAM studio that has maker supplies so they can start tinkering and also working on the engineering design process. We also have imagination playground, we have exhibits. We also bring in guest presenters to do interactive activities. And then we have a girls club, we have a conservation ecology internship, and we also do outreach at schools and doing an exploring engineering field trip. They're already natural scientists, natural engineers, so we're just offering the platform for that, and it's really wonderful because the parents are seeing that as well and continuing the learning at home. It's connecting people to science, but it's also connecting them to each other. This is a fun place. It's a place that's different that they probably never experienced. It's sort of a hybrid between a program and a traditional children's museum.
Okay, I'm starving at this point. It was time for a stop at McDonald's. And honestly, if you're asking me, the two no-brainers on the menu are two classics. The Big Mac, of course. Producer Rook wanted that. And the quarter pounder with cheese for me. You cannot beat that classic. And the fries here. I mean, they're McDonald's fries. They're always good. But these were particularly perfect. And it's a great location. It's on 183rd. And it was the fuel I needed for our day in Homewood.
It's still fresh.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
Oh.
But I wanted to give a shout out to Katz Milanec. They are an accounting firm that wants to see you grow, you or your business. They have a lot of different services, whether you have a business or it's just for you. They do help with taxes, financial management, business development, a lot of payroll stuff, headaches that you don't want for your business. They do fraud investigations, they handle that, tax audits, all sorts of stuff at Katz Milanec. But I think I saved my favorite activity, as always, for last.
Oh, it's been a great day in Homewood, everybody. This place seriously has it all. A great South Suburban community. But no stop here is complete without coming to the Ravisloe Country Club. Everybody says you have to come out here, so of course, we made a stop on by. Great facility. And I'm not gonna come out here without taking a swing or two, right? So I teed this up. Here we go. This is a legit first swing of the day. Really the first swing in a long time. By the way, what a great visit to Homewood. Let's hope to visit your hometown next on WGN. And here we go. Oh, that was straight down the middle. Seriously, I think that was my best drive of the year. Thank you, Homewood. That was terrible.